Ladies and gentlemen, Yokohama Committee of the ISSF welcome Nicosia 2022. And the ISSF welcome you at the first semi-final of the skip main event. The four athletes of the first semi-final will proceed for the shoot-off. And then we will present the target.
Hello, welcome to the ISSF World Cup Shotgun in Nicosia, Cyprus. We're at the Olympic shooting range in Nicosia, getting ready for the second final of the day. We just finished with the women's finals, and now we're starting with the men's final. It's going to be two relays, where two of the finalists are going in to the medal match from each of the relay. I think the wind is starting to be a little bit less than it was throughout the day, and it's 11 degrees Celsius, so it's not as warm as we're used to here in Cyprus, but at least the sun is out, so it can warm the finalists at least a little bit. We're in Nicosia, the largest city, capital of Cyprus, and on a beautiful shooting range. Here everything is green around us, the center of Cyprus. It's the first day of skeet competitions. The last 3 days were only trap, and the next 2 days will be skeet as well. The athletes, the finalists, are ready to begin with the first relay. We have one Italian representative, one French, one from Denmark, and one from Czech Republic. These four representatives competing for their place in the medal match.
In position number 4, with bib number 7, representing Czech Republic, Jan Zamaznik.
First of all, coming out from Czech Republic, Jan.
In position number 3,
Zamaznik.
Bib number 5, representing Denmark,
competing for his
Hansen.
Place in the medal match. Then we have from Denmark, Jasper Hansen.
With bib number 3, representing France, Eric Delaunay.
Next up is the French representative.
And in position number 1,
Eric Delaunay.
Bib number also number 1, representing Italy, Tamaro Cassandro.
And Tamaro Cassandro from Italy.
The jury member in charge for the first semi-final, Mr. Yannis Hierakleos from Cyprus. And referee, Mr. Pierre Bourgeois from France.
We have the officials conducting the finals.
Good luck to all athletes. Let the first semifinal begin.
And we're starting from station number 3. That's the first station that they will be shooting from. Tamara Cassandra from Italy, Eric Delaney from France, Jasper Hansen from Denmark, and Jan Zamechnik from Czech Republic. First of all, they'll be shooting 20 targets before one of them leaves the finals, and it will be in station 3, 4 targets. That's 2 doubles, 1 normal, 1 reverse. That means high house, low house is the normal, the reverse is low house, high house. It's the way that they have to shoot by the rules. Then on station 4, the second station that they'll be shooting from, it's only 2 targets, and it's a normal double in the first round. And then on station number 5, the third station they'll be shooting from, 4 targets again, 2 doubles, 1 normal, 1 reverse, where the normal double is shooting first the low target, low house target, then the high house target. After the 20 targets, one of the athletes is leaving the finals, and the 3 that remain will continue with the next 10 targets when we will have the decision of who are the 2 going into the medal match. We have not had a miss yet by Cassandra or Delaney, as well as Hansen now, hitting both high house target and the low house target. Let's see if he can do the perfect 4 like Cassandra and Delaney. And he does. Coming to Zamechnik, the youngest of the 4. He's 25. And he's the only one with a miss so far.
After station 3,
actually 3 Amaro, misses in
Eric
a row.
And Jesper are equal with 4 hits out of 4 targets. Jan with 1 hit out of 4 targets. We move to station 4.
Not a very good start for the Czech Republic representative. Next station, here they have only 1 double. It's the normal double. Calling of the target. And a few seconds pass, and the targets come out of the high house and the low house. And differently from Trap, the skeet competitors, finalists, shoot 2 targets at a time. The speed in which the targets fly out in Trap is 80 kilometers per hour, and in skeet it's a bit less than that. They're not flying out as fast as in Trap. And these two disciplines are similar, but very different at the same time. Zamechnik again with a miss, the only one in the first station, actually station number 3, and he had 1 miss in station number 4. We're coming to the last station of the first round of the first 10 targets. Now the normal double is first low house, high house. And the reverse double is high house, low house. This is Cassandra's first miss. It seems like we're having a bit of a technical difficulties with the broadcast with the big It's back now. Hopefully it will stay this way. Delaney's first miss as well. Cassandro and Dalnair are tied now. Hansen has a chance to take the lead. Just two more hits. In the reverse double, which means now high house target first, then low house target. He hits both of the targets and takes the lead. Zamechnik. He's not in a really good position. He only had two hits so far, and now he's coming to a total of four. We'll see if he'll be able to get out of this situation.
The third target, Jesper Hansen, is leading with no miss. Tamara Cassandro and Eric Delaney with nine hits. Jan Smenik with six hits.
Right, after 10 targets, Hansen in the lead. 10 hits, he had not had a miss yet. Cassandro and Delaney tied. And Zamechnik is holding the last place so far. One more round. Cassandro continuing on. It's a really good score. Delaney needs two more hits now to tie with Cassandro, not to be left behind. And he does, coming to a total of 13 hits. Hansen still not missing any of the targets. Nice. Keeping his lead in the finals. It's really questionable if Zamechnik will be able to hold his position in the finals and stay.
After 14 targets,
did have yes, one more miss again, no miss. While Cassandro Delaney and Hansen
and John
had no misses in the in station number three. Nicely done. So now this is the reverse double. First low house, then high house target. And Cassandro and Delaney both went easily through this station. Hansen now missed one. So he tied with Cassandro Delaney. And Zamechnik now came to a total of 11 hits, but it's not looking probable for him to stay in the finals. last station. And Cassandra finishing off with 19 hits out of 20 targets. Let's see if Delaney can do the same. He has two more targets. And it looks like he missed both of the targets. Hansen also had a miss, which means that Cassandra takes the lead now. He did a very satisfying final so far. And this is going to be it for Zamechnik. No matter what are the hits now, there is no possibility for him to stay in the finals. He just had too many misses. And unfortunately, he does not get to go into the medal match.
Tamara Cassandra leading with 19 hits. Jesper Hansen follows with 18 hits. And Eric Delaney
so
with 17 hits.
Zamechnik
from Czech Republic, is
Czech Republic takes
hits.
The fourth place.
So and two for the next 10
now we have three left. Tamara Cassandra, Jesper Hansen, and Eric Delaney. Delaney had the last two misses on the last station, which cost him a bit, and he fell into the third place now. Cassandra is continuing strongly, even though he had one miss. It's still a really, really good result to have 22 hits after 24 targets. No one can tie with him in this moment. So he is in a good position. If he continues in this way, he has a place in the medal match. Only if Hansen now hits two more targets will he be able to tie with Cassandra. And he does, coming to a tie with Cassandra.
Jesper are equal with 22 hits.
22 hits by both of these finalists. Delaney is on the line with only one hit less. So we will just have to wait and see. Bravo. All right, two hits by Cassandra. Delaney was missed one more. It's let's see what they think. It looked like maybe it could have been a hit, but I'm sure they're gonna ask for VAR here.
VAR protest for Jesper Starkes.
And yes, they do, asking for VAR for Hansen. It is really important to be sure in all of the hits. to the Denmark representative.
We are waiting for the confirmation of the result of the project.
Denmark.
From the VAR.
We're going to have to see what this Olympic silver medalist from last year did in the last two targets. One was a hit, that's sure. The question is about the second one. VAR says it's a miss. It's a miss for this Olympic silver medalist.
So after 26 targets,
and Amaro is leading with world champion,
Jesper with 23, and Eric with
back 2013.
Move to station 5.
We're coming to the last station, and Delaney is one hit behind. He won the World Cup back in silver medal back in 2019. Let's see if he can save his place now to go into the medal match. Cassandro, definitely the best one so far in the finals. He's been shooting since 2007 and winning the World Cup in Osijek last year. He seems very determined to do the same today, since out of 30 targets he had 27 hits. Delaney came to 26 hits, and it depends now on Hansen and what happens here. Hansen hits the two targets, two more, and he's safe.
No target.
There was no target. Two more, and there's no question about it. I think there's a bit of a technical issue with the targets, but Hansen is coming back to try again. And he missed one target, coming to a total of 26 hits, same as Delaney.
Jesper, Tamar Cassandro has qualified for the medal match with 27
Which means hits. Cassandro is safe, he's going into the medal match. And Hansen and Delaney are now going to have to go through a shoot-off. Okay, a few more moments before the shoot-off, just so the athletes can prepare themselves for this part, because it's not a part of the regular part of the finals. It's a shoot-off. So a few more moments and we get to see who between these two are going in the finals. And the medal match. And Delaney starts with two hits. Hansen now. They're shooting 2x2. First shooting the normal double. They both hit the targets. Going back to... the reverse double now, and I think... it's both hits, so it's no need for VAR. Delaney hit all four targets. It's up to Hansen now. He needs to hit to qualify. And it's one miss for Hansen, which means his finals is over. And unfortunately, he's not going to be going in the medal match, but Delaney has a reason to celebrate now, at least before coming to the medal match, where he gets to try out for bronze, silver, or gold medal. And he's the one who gets the chance to be on the podium.
We will continue with the second semifinal.
Tamara Cassandro from Italy with 27 hits in the end. It was just one hit of a difference between Cassandro and Delaney and Hansen. And shoot-off made it clear. The French representative is going into the medal match. The first relay is over. We have the first two names going into the medal match, and getting ready now for second relay, where we will have a representative from Egypt, then a representative from United Arab Emirates, and two representatives actually from Finland. So stay with us to find out who are the two competing for the medals alongside Tamara Cassandro and Eric Delaney. It's a beautiful sports kit. Comment, who are you rooting for? In the finals, we already have the first two names going in, first two finalists, and the second relay, we're just going to give us the two more finalists going into the medal match. It's just a few moments away.
The second semi-final of the skid men event is starting in Hawaii.
We will go into the second relay as soon as possible, but before that, let's see a director's cut of the shooting community and the environment and nature. Nature is the world around us. We as human beings depend on it, so we must protect it and take care of our nature that provides us more than just beauty, but life as well. In the shooting sport, the materials used are recyclable. It is important if we want to preserve the environment. Competition and training take place outdoors, so the shooting sport community is in touch with nature every day. Athletes are encouraged from an early age to be attentive when dealing with the environment. The shooting sport community is seriously committed to keep Mother Nature clean, as well as to recycle all materials that are used in training and competition. Let's hold each other accountable and help Earth become a clean and healthy place again. All right, getting ready for relay two. The athletes are doing some test fire. As I said, one representative from Egypt, one from United Arab Emirates, and two from Finland will be competing for their place in the medal match. That will be right after this second relay. First one was very interesting. In the end, we even had a shoot-off. That was the first shoot-off of the day. We'll see if these four get to settle everything without a shoot-off. So once again, starting from zero, these four finalists are going to be shooting 20 targets first. Four targets station three, two targets station four, four targets station five, twice. After which we'll have the decision of who is definitely not in the medal match. Finally, we have some spectators, I think, that says that the wind is a bit lighter now than it was. And it's a bit easier being outside, but it's vividly cold. As we can see, everybody is kind of trying to warm themselves, but loving this sport. We want to see what happens. Thankfully, we also have this broadcast so that everyone interested all over the world gets to see it as well.
With bib number 8, representing Finland, Lari Pesonen.
First athlete coming out from Finland, Lari Pesonen. This 27-year-old.
In position number 2.
Then from the United Arab Emirates, Saif bin Futais, a 48-year-old, still in the top of the shooting sport, Etu Kalyonen. I think he's the youngest one here, 23.
Jury member in charge for this semifinal, Mr. Yannis Irakleos.
And then coming in from Egypt, Azmi Mehelba. Yannis Irakleos from Cyprus will be the jury in charge of this finals.
Good luck to all.
And Loisiu from Cyprus as well will be the referee. So Egypt, Finland, and United Arab Emirates competing for their place in the medal match. Azbi Behelba, Tukalionen, Saif Bin Futais, and Lari Pesonen starting on station number 3 with 4 targets, 2 normal. So a normal double, which is target from the high house, first being shot, then target from the low house. And then we have the reverse double, which is first shooting low house target, then the high house target. In station number 3. We're gonna start now, as it seems, with with the Mehelba shooting first and hitting both of the targets in the normal double. Finishing off with a perfect perfect series. Now, Kalionen, as I said, the youngest one, who placed fourth at the Olympics in Tokyo last year. So hopefully he will have more luck in this competition. First miss of Relay 2, Kalionen's last target. Bin Futais. World Cup winner from 2015 in Larnaca. That is another shooting range here in Cyprus. As we can imagine, it's always a nice, it's always nice weather here, so it's very good for shooting trap and skit. This time it's a bit different with all of the wind, but still a beautiful scenery. Nevertheless, Pesonen started with two hits. Let's see now with the reverse double. He hits both of the targets. After the only miss was by Kalionen, the youngest one here, which could kind of show that, you know, experience means a lot. In life, in sports, especially in the sport where it's possible to have a career for a long time, more than most of the sports. It's not damaging. It's actually doing good for mental strengthening, as well as good physical health, because these athletes are not just shooting. They're also doing different kinds of exercises so that they keep fit and keep themselves well to be able to endure these competitions. You can imagine flying all over the world, shooting in different shooting ranges. It could take out from the person, so they need to have a lot of strength, both mental and physical, to be able to do what they do and show off these marvelous skills. And the beautiful, beautiful discipline that skeet is. They're always shooting two targets. Now we're coming to the fifth station to finish with the first 10 targets. So here the normal double is shooting first the low house target, then the high house target, and the reverse double is high house target, low house target. And I think he had one miss, yes. Now for the I think he's gonna ask for VAR. Maybe let's just give it a moment. Helba thinks it's a hit, so let's see now. The VAR is going to decide. Well, the referees looking at the VAR are going to decide.
The jury in charge with the referee according to the VAR.
We're watching at the official review. That's the target right there. And I think the decision was very fast. The referee is going to come out now. To let us know the decision is a hit. The decision is a hit, so it's a good thing Mehelba asked for a VAR. He was sure that this was a hit. He's coming now to shoot the reverse double in the fifth station. That means he'll be shooting the high house target first, then the low house target. He hit only the low house target. But it's a good score, coming to a total of 10 targets. He hits 9. Which is not a bad result. Two more hits for Kalionen, and he'll be one hit behind Mehelba if he manages to do so. But he missed one. So he is two hits behind Mehelba. Good thing there's 10 more targets after this round. So Kalonen will still have a few more chances. Stay in the finals and go to the medal match. But as I said, he is the youngest one, and it's always a good experience to compete next to such a strong competition as these finalists here are. Pesonen. Last one on the last station. One hit, one miss by this 27-year-old. who started competing back in 2010. He has been already competing 12 years, and that's not that long of a career in shooting sports, especially having someone as Saif bin Futais, who has been competing since 1999. That's 23 years ago. Now had one miss here in the first station, and as we can see in this total picture, we have a few smushes on the camera from the pink powder flying through the air because of the wind. So it's all total for Mehelba, 10 total for Kalyanen. Futais coming to a total of 12 as well. And we're going to see now for Pesonen on this station number 3, first station of the second round. Two more hits and he could be in the lead. And he manages to do exactly that. The representative from Finland took over the lead with 13 hits total. Mehelba and Bin Futais are tied now with both having 12 hits. And Kalyanen is in the last place currently. With 10 hits. It is the reverse double now on the middle station. And these finalists are not just fighting the finals, they're also fighting the wind. They were all successful in this middle station so far. The only miss is by Pesonen. Pesonen coming to a total of 14, which means 3 of the finalists are actually tied after 16 targets. We have a the last station, the fifth station, to decide about one of the finalists leaving the finals. And so far it looks like Kalyanen might be the one who has to leave first, the youngest one in the finals. He is 2 hits behind the rest of them. And Mehelba now had a perfect series. as well. You can now only count on someone else's misses. To maybe try and stay, but we're gonna see. We still have two more finalists to finish the station. One miss by Benfodais. And one more miss. And we're going to see what happens with these two that tied. Pessonen hits the two targets. I think he missed these two. And now we have three ties. Kalionen, Benfutis, and Pessonen. But because he had the highest BIP number, he's the one to first leave, and he was in such a great position. He could have stayed, but see, just the smallest mistake, and unfortunately, he fell out of the finals. The Finnish representative, Lari Pessonen, will not be continuing with the finals, but the three remaining have 10 more targets before the decision of who are the two going into the medal match. Helba starting with the perfect finish of the station number three. Kalionen. It was not looking good for him, but in the end, look, he stayed. So far, he still has a chance. And with this, he's just increasing his chances with this perfect four hits that he just had. Benfutis can tie with Kalionen now. So we saw a shoot-off in the last relay. It looks like we might have won this one as well, but we're gonna see now. Futeis had two misses.
Asmir Mehelpa is leading with 22 hits. Eto Kalioinen with 20 hits. And Zaifin Futeis with 18 hits. We continue with station four.
And we're going into the middle station, station four. Now it's a normal double again. So first hitting the high house target, then the low house target. But does a good job here. Kalionen now has a chance to. There was no target. Kalionen now has a chance to go into the medal match. Two hits.
After station four and 26 targets, Asim Mehelpa with 24 hits.
We're coming to the last station to see who gets to go fight for gold.
Continuous station five.
Currently, Benfutis is on the third place with 20 targets. hit. Kalyanen with 22 targets hit in the second place. And currently leading is Mihelba, who's also shooting first with a total of that he had 24, now 26. Now for the reverse double, high house, low house in the last station. One hit, one miss. Yes. That's it, but it's he can be really pleased. He's going in. He is safe. Going into the medal match. It would be really good for Kalyanen to have at least one more hit so that he can be safe as well. And he does it. This 23-year-old is able to secure his place and try and get to the podium. Been for days now for his last station, but it's pretty clear that the two going into the medal match are the Egyptian representative and Finland representative. The one that started off not so good, but then managed to take his place in the medal match. Azmi Mihelba from Egypt qualified to be in the race for gold, alongside two Kalyanen from Finland to go in to the medal match. Stay with us, we'll be right on with the medal match, as we just saw the two relays and found out who will be the four in the last part of the finals. I'm going to show us who will be the best at the ISSF World Cup in Nicosia, Cyprus 2022 for Shotgun, happening in this windy weather that I'm sure everybody will remember very well. And while we wait for the beginning of the medal match, last final of the day, we're going to watch a director's cut about this wonderful discipline, skeet. Skeet shooting discipline, practiced at the Olympics since 1968. Unlike trap, in skeet, the athletes shoot two targets at a time. One coming from the left, called high house target, and one coming from the right, low house target. The targets are made of clay and break easily when hit with a ball shot, that are precisely examined in equipment control to ensure fair play. Men and women compete in this discipline, cultivating exceptional coordination and concentration to be able to successfully hit both targets one by one in a very limited span of time. The skill requires fast reaction, since athletes have to be able to quickly take the shotgun in position right before aiming and shooting the targets. Skeet, a marvelous discipline challenging both physical and mental abilities. The athletes now have a chance to do some test fire, but there will be no showing of the targets since they went through the targets through the first and the second relay. So just getting ready for the medal match, the thing that we are here for, to see who gets to climb the podium and celebrate the victory today.
The test fire procedure for the four finalists of the medal match.
We're just a few moments away from the beginning. It's really interesting how, amusingly enough, this sport is the safest in the world, even though the athletes are dealing with the shotguns here. Safety is a big deal in the shooting sport community. And the first thing that every athlete learns is dealing with safety and how to be disciplined. It encourages really discipline and respectful behavior towards towards guns, as well as other athletes and the whole shooting community. Our athletes are very respectful when it comes to handling guns, and they take safety very seriously. Now, coming out first in the medal match, Etu Kalionen from Finland. It's really marvelous how he got in. This young shooter, only 23, he is the youngest one in the medal match. Eric Delaney from France coming out.
And in position number
and
one,
then we have Azmi Mehelba from Egypt, 30-year-old who has been in the shooting sport since 2006, competing. And last but not least, Tamara Cassandro from Italy, to fight for gold. These are the four athletes, the four finalists, the four best ones today at the ISSF World Cup in Shotgun, Nicosian, Cyprus 2022. Tamara Cassandra, Azmi Mehelba, Eric Delaney, and Etu Kalionen. We have four nations competing for the medals in the last final of the day, the last medal match. Starting off, first is Tamara Cassandro.
Bravo.
And he had three hits. All right. Cassandra is 28 years old. He placed sixth in the last Olympic Games, but today he seems very, very determined. We're gonna see how he does in the finals. Mehelba. Mehelba doing nicely in the first station.
For Eric Delaney's target.
Delaney asking for a VAR. We're only at the first station.
The jury in charge together with the referee in the VAR room to clarify the result of the target.
It's the official review. We can see the target flying out. We're gonna have to wait for the referee's decision. Let's see what they decided on this one target from Delaney. It's a hit, the referee says. Good for Delaney for asking for VAR. It is here for a reason. And with this, he gets the perfect four hits and his in station number three, the first station that they're shooting from. Kalionen, very good for this young athlete who just is at the beginning of his career, even though he has been shooting for a long time, but now he's coming to an age where he can definitely be a good competition.
We continue with station four.
Station number four, and the first round means normal double. which means first hitting the high house target, then the low house target. Again, we can see the spots on the camera from the pink powder and also on everyone's clothes. So it shows us a little bit how the wind is blowing the powder all over the shooting range. One miss by Delaney. Cassandro and Delaney are now tied. Mahelba hadn't had a miss yet. And Kalionen is in the last place. His coach is probably nervous now to see what happens with his athletes. The connection between the athletes and the coaches in shooting sports is a very high one. They are not only here for the physical exercise of the sport, but also have to really deeply know and understand their athletes so they can be able to guide them in the right direction throughout their career. Because this sport has a lot of mental struggles sometimes, you can say. Mahelba doing very well. He's the only one who hadn't had a miss yet. So far in this last station number five, only Cassandro and Mahelba so far had a perfect four hits. Let's see if Kalionen can do the same. Kalionen, his coach is going to ask for VAR.
The jury in charge with the referee of
proceedings to the VAR is sure that he hit the target. Let's see. A bronze medalist from the European Championship last year in Osijek 2021. Had been winning medals as a junior yet as well, so potentially he has a long and wonderful career ahead. The referees are now reviewing targets. Them flying by. Let's see. Maybe. It looks like this could be a hit. This could be a hit.
The referee is coming.
All right, let's see. The decision for Kalionen. Hopefully it's at least one hit. And VAR says it's one hit. Only the second one is hit.
Mihalpa is leading with
they
no
say,
miss at all, with 10 hits. Tamaro Cassandro with one miss, 9 hits. Eric Delaney with 8 hits. And Eto Kallioinen with 7 hits.
So Kallioinen came to a total of 7 hits. Delaney to a total of 8 hits. Cassandro 9. Helba is keeping the lead with 10 hits so far, not one miss. Curious to see what he does throughout the rest of the finals.
Bravo!
Very nicely done. Good by Mihalba, this World Cup winner from last year in Lonato. He won the silver in World Cup twice, 2018 and 2016 as well. And he already won the bronze here in Nicosia in 2020. Now he's determinedly for the gold. As any of these athletes, I mean, they came so far, they are in the four best at this competition. And now it's still just the decision of who will be the best among these four. Kallioinen now has a chance to tie with Delaney.
After 14 targets, Tamara and Azmi are equal with 15 hits.
He was successful.
Eric and Eto are equal with 11 hits. We move to station 4.
But now we're coming to station number 4. It's the middle station. It's the reverse double now. Hitting first the low house target, then the high house target. Helba does a great job here, coming to a total of 15. But it's not going to be enough for Kallioinen to just be tied with Delaney. He needs to have one hit more if he wants to stay in the finals because of his beat number.
After station 4 and 16 targets.
And he also missed one target now. So his chances are a little bit lower in this moment. They still have to go through four more targets. Before one of them leaves the finals, not having a place on the podium. And the Finnish coach looks a bit worried now, but it's not lost yet.
Bravo!
Cassandro is on a roll here. Out of 20 targets, he only had 2 misses. Mihalba so far only had 1 miss. If he hits this reverse double, high house target, low house target, he'll keep his lead, but was able to shoot only one of the targets, so Cassandro and Mihalba are now tied. And it looks like it's going to be between Delaney and Kallioinen on which one is staying in the race for gold. Delaney now had a miss. It's a pretty nerve-wracking moment. Let's see. One more miss for Delaney. Kalyona now needs all four hits. And unfortunately, no. The coach had a reaction. He knew it was what's going on here. And
after the end of series one and the first 20 targets, Tamara Cassandra and Abin Mekerpa are equal with.
Unfortunately, because of the beep number, he was so close, but all the rest of competition also affects the finals, so Kalyona here just needed one more hit.
We'll continue to the next 10 targets, the second series.
And the Finnish representative got so far in the finals, but in the end, the fourth place is his. He has potentially a long career in front of him, so this is a great success as well. Eetu Kalyonen winning the fourth place. And now what stays is just a question of gold, silver, and bronze between Tamara Cassandra, Azmi Mehelba, and Eric Delaney. In the next 10 targets, we're going to find out who's the bronze medalist.
Bravo.
Again, Delaney is in a position where he needs to have at least one more hit. It's not going to be enough for him to tie because it's not a shoot-off situation for the bronze medal, only for the gold. Everything else is decided by the beep number, which corresponds to the result of qualification and the semifinals. And Mehelba continuing on great. It's going to be really interesting to see what happens between Cassandra and Mehelba, because both of them are tied even now, after 24 targets, and Delaney is the one who is not in the best position, but still they have 6 more targets, so we'll see.
After the first station of the second series and 24 targets, Tamaro and Azmi are equal with 22 hits, Eric with 18 hits. We continue to station 4.
Tamara Cassandra ready for station number 4, where they only have one double.
Bravo.
In this case, it's again the normal double, which means the first target they have to shoot, is coming from the high house, and the second target to shoot is coming from the low house. Done by both Cassandra and Mehelba. Delaney unfortunately lost his chances with this miss. And it's pretty obvious now who is the bronze medalist, because Delaney cannot reach these two who are definitely in the race for gold. So far, they had only 2 misses each from the whole finals. So it's an impressive work by these two, and I'm really excited to see what happens with the gold medal. It's going to be a battle between Cassandro and Mehelba. Mehelba with two more hits could tie with Cassandro again. They have been tied most of the finals. And now they're tied again. Eric Delaney's last four targets before winning the bronze medal at the ISSF World Cup. And Nicosia Cyprus, this 34-year-old, is the bronze medalist. And he is definitely in for a celebration today. Because it's a great thing.
Tamaro and Azmi still equal with 27 hits out of 30 targets and move to series three.
And really valuable medal as well. Bronze medalist Eric Delaney from France finishing his finals with 23 hits out of 30 targets. We gotta give it out for Cassandro and Mehelba, who have only had three misses so far in the finals and now will show us who wins the gold in this competition. That will be maybe remembered as the windiest shotgun competition in Cyprus. This is a moment that these athletes train for. This is a moment when they have to make sure to be in really good condition with their mental and physical abilities. This is what they train for. These last 10 targets are the deciding, and everything can happen in just such a quick
after station three
moment. And see now Mehelba with this one miss is one behind Cassandro. Now Cassandro needs to take this in and be able to hold the pressure of being in the lead in the race for the gold. All right, the coach is on his feet, starting to be pretty nerve-wracking. Mehelba hits the both of the targets.
After station four and 36 targets.
I think the last station will decide. Unless, of course, they come to a shoot-off. I would not be surprised, but let's see if they can settle this here on the last station. Without going for the shoot-off. Okay, Cassandro is holding on this final so well. And it's two misses by Cassandro. This is where he is giving the chance to Mehelba. He didn't have two misses in a row throughout the whole finals. That's the pressure. Now he gave a chance to Cassandro, to Mehelba. Hits the two targets. Two more, and the gold is his. Come to the last two targets. And it's two hits by Mehelba, winning the gold medal here at the ISSF World Cup. In Nicosia, Cyprus, he was the determined one from the beginning, and he wins the gold. Asmi Mehelba from Egypt with the last perfect series of four hits in the last station. Last year at the World Cup in Lonato, he won the gold as well now here in Nicosia, winning the gold. And Tamara Cassandro, the Italian representative, wins the silver. He fought a good fight, this 20-year-old. He won the World Cup in Osijek last year. He has his gold from the World Cup, but today he wins the silver, while Asmi Mehelba gets to celebrate his gold and bring it back to Egypt. Asmi Mehelba, the gold medalist, Tamara Cassandro, silver medalist, and Eric Delaney, the French representative, winning the bronze at the ISSF World Cup in shotgun. We get to see these beautiful slow motion shots of the targets. Athletes, it's kind of a satisfying feeling when the target is hit. The powder, the pink powder, goes everywhere since it's so windy here. Hopefully tomorrow we'll have a little bit of a better situation with the weather. But make sure to come back tomorrow, because we have the final for mixed team event for skeet. Again, the first 3 days were reserved for trap. We have 3 days of skeet. First day is finished, two more days. Tomorrow is the mixed team event. It's going to start at 3:15 local time. Make sure to come back and continue on watching the athletes compete at this World Cup. That gold shot by Mehelba. So that was it for today. Last finals is finished. Tomorrow, 3:15, we are back with the mixed team event. Come back and support your athletes, and make sure to follow the official pages of ISSF on Facebook and Instagram, so you can see all of these broadcasts being live to you, currently coming from Cyprus. I saw a person coming with this.